explaining about the Java database connectivity, JDBC. Now first, what is JDBC? Why we use JDBC? JDBC is nothing but Java database connectivity. JDBC is mainly for interconnect between the Java applications and database and Java applications. We execute SQL queries from the database by using with interconnect with JDBC Java. First we see the definition. To communicate with the different vendors of variety of data stores, you can use JDBC. Java applications and different vendors of database. JDBC specification, we use XOpen and XCS standards for database. Standard in the low level specifications of database, these two are. And JDBC uses SQL structure query language instructions standards to execute the instructions. JDBC allows the Java applications to execute queries, SQL queries in the database. JDBC is nothing but it allows the database to execute the SQL queries. Next, what is JDBC driver? JDBC driver is nothing but the specification implemented by third-party vendors is known as JDBC driver. JDBC driver, it is the implementation part of these there are 250 vendors are there. JDBC driver done these things. Next, what is JDBC driver? JDBC driver is a set of well-defined classes implements the JDBC specifications. JDBC driver is set of well-defined classes that implements the JDBC specifications. There are 250 plus JDBC drivers are available. Next we see JDBC basic architecture. JDBC consists of first level is Java application, second level is JDBC API application interface, next level is third party vendors implementation. First level is JDBC application, second level is JDBC API, next level is third party vendors. Here third party vendors, examples of third party vendors is Oracle, it is one example, SQL Server, it is one example, and other databases. Oracle software, SQL Server software, we can store the databases, we can execute the databases from this Oracle software, SQL Server software. These are called as a third party vendors. JDBC driver can do interconnect with these vendors. Based on this approach, JDBC divided into some four types of drivers: type 1, type 2, type 3, type 4. Four drivers are there. First, we see type 1 driver. JDBC type 1 driver. Type 1 driver, it converts the JDBC calls into ODBC calls, open database connectivity. It is called as a type 1 driver. Type 1 driver, what it can do? First, Java applications, and then interconnect with the JDBC ODBC bits driver. Okay, here in between these JDBC API is there. JDBC calls, Java applications send the JDBC calls to JDBC ODBC driver, and again this bits driver connect with the ODBC driver. In between these two, native ODBC call is there. ODBC call, JDBC ODBC bridge driver, it can call the ODBC call to ODBC driver, and ODBC driver, it will be interconnected to the different vendors like Oracle, SQL Server, Sybase, all these things. Like four levels are there. First one is Java application. Second level is JDBC ODBC bridge driver. Third level is ODBC driver. Fourth level is vendors, SQL, Oracle, all these things. Between this, first JDBC calls will send the Java application. Next, ODBC calls send the JDBC ODBC driver. Next, DBMS specific calls, it will send to ODBC driver, send to the these vendors, Oracle, all these things. This is the total execution of JDBC ODBC type 1 driver. Main advantages of this driver is it is a single driver implementation, can be used to communicate with the different databases. Here we use single driver implementation for the different databases. This is one advantage with this one. Next advantage is we can use this driver to commute to the all databases specified by ODBC. We can use this driver to communicate with the all databases specified by ODBC. There is nothing but one ODBC driver communicate with all databases. Only one ODBC driver. Next, disadvantages for this one. Because of the number of conversions like JDBC to ODBC and ODBC to database, here two conversions are there, JDBC to ODBC and ODBC to database. So specific native calls to this driver, speed of the operation is slow. So two types of conversions are there, no? So speed is somewhat low. So where we use this driver, this one, this can be used in the development phase to test the functionality of applications. Can be used in the development phase. This can be reference, this can be given as a reference implementation. It includes JDK, Java Development Kit. Next one is type 2 driver. So operation is low, so that we can use type 2 driver. Some improvement to JDBC first driver. This driver converts JDBC calls to database specific calls. It is known as a type 2. JDBC to direct database calls. No need of ODBC, all these things. Convert JDBC calls to database specific API calls. So here there are only three levels are there. First one is Java application, and then type 2 driver is there. Type 2 driver take the JDBC calls with JDBC API application interface, and then this driver directly connect to the database. No need of ODBC, all these things. It can do the native call to databases. So again, do the operation. Only three levels are there. The conversion from JDBC calls to database specific calls is performed by JVM, client JVM. They have a virtual machine. Where we use JVM, JDBC calls to database specific calls. JDBC to database, this one between the, you can use JVM, Java Virtual Machine. Okay, next one is, in this type of driver we can use JNI, Java Native Interface, to invoke the native functions. To invoke the native functions, we can use JNI, Java Native Interface. here what are the advantages are there. This one, it is the fastest driver compared to the all other drivers, and disadvantages. Database specific native libraries has to be installed into the client machine. So client machine database libraries are installed. Here's some disadvantages. Memory loss is there. If the driver use the native functions that are not bug free, then it may result the crash to JVM. JVM will be crashed. JVM crash. This is some disadvantages there. Next, where we use this driver. If we want our server side to communicate with the database, server side communicate with the database, we want that one, we can use this one, this type 2 driver. For this one, we can confirm that it is bug free. All these things are there. Compulsory, we have to check it is bug free and does not disturbance to the other drivers. So we can use this type 2. This type of driver is database dependent. It follows two-tier architecture model. Okay, next is type 3 driver. Type 3 driver is nothing but JDBC driver that converts JDBC calls to database independent and middleware server specific native calls, network calls. JDBC driver that converts JDBC calls to database independent and middleware specific network calls. It is known as type 3 driver. Convert network calls. You can see type 3 driver architecture. It follows 3-tier architecture. Here first one is Java application and it is linked to the type 3 driver. To the JDBC call to type 3 driver, and type 3 linked again to the middleware server. The middleware server, server driver is there. The middleware server, it can be connected to the vendors like Oracle, SQL, all these things. Type 3 driver can be linked to the server. These server specific network calls, it can call the server specific network call to middleware server. The middleware server, it can do all the native DBMS specific calls, all these things. So the only 3-tier architecture only. These vendors operations, it will do middleware server. So what are the advantages for type 3? It is lightweight driver. Java. It is database independent. Lightweight driver and database independent. And sensitive database. It is like database location. And username, password, all these things are not required for this one. So with the driver, with this type of driver, the resources can be managed better. This middleware server is somewhat intelligent compared to other one. It improves the performance. Next, disadvantages. Because of this middleware server is there, so the cost of the driver is more. Cost is more compared to the other drivers. This is some disadvantage. So in the type 3 driver, we can use applets here. So most of the projects, this type 3 driver is used mostly. and next one is last driver type 4 driver. This driver convert the JDBC calls to JDBC specific network call. Is known as a type 4 driver. It follows two tier architecture only. The type of driver is database independent. So now we see the architecture. Java application, it can call the JDBC call to JDBC 4 driver, type 4 driver. Okay. Type 4 driver, it is again connected to the database. It will do call database specific call to database. Here it will perform the operation of abstract into toolkit, all these things. Okay, in the next class we can do JDBC API.